Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with some more Let's Play this here Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin. And we are continuing with our escapades. Fuck me. We are continuing with our escapades in the Iron Keep. Which, you know what, despite the fact that I complain quite aggressively about the actual geography of this spot and how little sense it makes. Ooh, that was a lovely nice dollop of damage. Oh, of course, it's bleed. Of course it does a huge amount of damage. But as much as I complain about, like, the fact that this place makes zero sense geographically, I do still quite actually like this area, even though I believe it's generally considered to be one of the cheaper areas, and I totally understand why, because it's bollocks. Although, it may actually be slightly less cheap in Scholar of the First Sin. In fact, it seems that is very much the case, because I'm not seeing one of the big things that rendered this place to be generally considered... rendered this place to be considered horrible bullshit. That being, there were like four archers in various different locales all around the area. Like, there's one here who's a bit of an irritant, but there used to be like five of them. Like, it was ridiculous how many bloody snipers there were. Like, they were literally everywhere. Hi there, buddy. And I mean literally everywhere. Like, you couldn't fucking move without getting hit by these bastards. Like, it was dreadful. It was utterly fucking dreadful. Ooh, a life ring? Life ring plus one? Oh, I forgot we were fucking wearing the Ring of the Evil Eye. I really need that. Yeah, it's not really a necessity, though. You know, I almost feel sorry for this guy. Because I genuinely think that because of his placement, he doesn't have anything he can do against me. Short of just, like, run around, really. It's also becoming quite clear that this is a man who doesn't react well to lacerating arrows, and that he doesn't react at all to lacerating arrows. Ah, well, he's dead now. Don't really need to bother with him all that much. What the hell was I getting at? I was talking about something. Oh yeah, this area used to be a lot more bullshit just because of the sheer number of snipers that were all over the shop. But right now, it seems that all the snipers are fucked off, so... Well, not all of them. There's still, you know, we did deal with two of them. You know, we had the big guy we just killed here, and we had the other guy over there, but specifically, there used to be one. And he was... I'm trying to think of where the other one actually was. Oh yeah, he was there. Oh, and he is still there, just he's not doing anything right now. Actually, that guy's carrying a sword, so he looks like he might be an ambusher, but... he was there, was the point, and he would just shoot at you no matter where you went on the map. Also, don't trust that. Don't open that door. If I need to explain to you why you shouldn't open the door that's belching fire, like... You've got problems beyond what I can help. I'm gonna be frank. Hello, friend. Goodbye, friend. This area is actually being a lot... Yeah, this area is being a lot more... reasonable than I'm used to. Oh, hello. Ah, fuck, two of you. Oops. Whoops-a-daisy. And down I go. Okay. Okay, and it begins. Now begins the problems that we're gonna have. Now begins the problems that we're gonna have. Now begins the problems that we are very much going to have. Oh dear. We were doing very well though. This place was being nowhere near as much of a dick as I'm used to. Ow. Stop that. Oh, I almost think I might have actually been... No. I almost think I might have actually, benefited from, I was thought for a minute, I might benefit from the presence of... Actually, it just occurred to me, there's... Invaded by Dark Spirit Armorer Dennis! What the... Oh, fuck me. Look, mate, fucking, come on. Okay, good, the Alon Knight. Hang on a minute. I fucking remember you. You're that dude from who attacks you in... This is the fucking same phantom as the one that attacks you in, oh, I can't remember what it's called. The Forest of Fallen Giants. In that one area full of fucking turtle knights. The same guy! I remember because he's called Armorer and yet somehow has a fuck ton of spells and I never understood it. I mean, you're a lot less of a threat now. Whoa, fuck. If only because you're not, like, taking out my entire health bar in one hit anymore. Also, apparently you can't aim. That seems to be an issue you're currently suffering from. Good. Fuck you, huh? Okay, I'm not... Okay, well, he's gone, so he doesn't get to attack me again, so... Why didn't he attack me earlier when the fucking fencer came? There's like two fucking enemies attack me in the same... Two phantoms attack me in the same area. It's so very odd. Like, I was not expecting that. Got a ring from him. Blue clear stone. Oh, Sean's casting time. Well, that's super. That's super. I don't know about you, but me? I always need that shit. Yeah, I'm putting my normal mask back on. I don't know. The clown mask has its charms, but... This feels more me. This horrible, ugly iron mask feels a lot more me. Oh, suck that. Whoa. There's nothing quite like stopping an enemy mid-charge. Slapping him around. I was gonna say, I know for a fact there's another one of you in. Oh, cool! You haven't noticed me yet. And you're the one who surprised me before, aren't you? Well, you didn't surprise me that time. Okay. So. Let me tell you what I'm thinking. Let me tell you what I'm thinking. I'm thinking we lure these guys in here. If we can. Are they following? Oh, good, good. Good, they are following. I mean, I'm currently being an idiot, but... they were following. Oh, fuck it. Okay. There we go. Okay, so we lure them in there. Which means that they are no longer an issue, which means we can rush and go stab the shit out of the asshole on this bridge. Hello, friend. And then if we're not too stupid... okay, well, before I get killed again... oh my god! If we're not too stupid, leaps off the side! Fuck me. Sorry, I misclicked. I misclicked. Okay, new plan. No, got a new plan. Got a new plan here, and that new plan is get straight to the fucking boss. So I know where the boss is, and we currently don't have anything to lose. So, draw this asshole out. Hey, stop firing at me. Come on, asshole. Come on. Good boy. Ow. Quit it. Just because I killed your friends, I mean, you have the right to kill me. For this round, I did just hear an arrow, but I don't know from where. Oh, from you. I still don't actually know what the enemy layout in this area is, because that guy always throws me. I don't actually know where he is. Like, is there... oh, fuck. Okay, good. Problem solved. Lovely. But yeah, so we also draw the guy who's out here into here. Deal with him. Get shot in the face. Good. And now we run to the boss door. Ow. Ow. You know, you can stop this anytime you want. Ow. You can also stop this anytime you want. Okay, good. Well, I just fucking cleared out the level. Okay, so we just got a black steel katana. Which we will have to take a look at later. Actually, from the looks of that, I think that's a pure... whoop! Sorry! Sorry, friend. No. Okay. I guess we can't run to the fog door. We have to clear the area. Although, frankly, it seems like if I'm a bit more careful, we won't have that much of an issue in terms of clearing the area out. Because apparently these fuckers are happy to get into a conga line. So what I need to do... what I need to do... actually, what might be a good idea is a human effigy thing. I never use my human effigies. I mean, I have them, but I never fucking use the bloody things. I have loads, and they never get used. But what may be a good idea... yeah, what I think we're gonna have to do is just... like, clear all these guys out as a matter of course. I mean, they're not actually that much of a problem. It's just that at that very end point, I kind of... They swarm you a bit, and you've got very limited movement space, so I kind of panic. Come on down. Come on. Good boy. I love it when you guys just do what I say. It makes the end become very fucking nigh very fucking quickly. Oh, I know where you come from now. Okay, no, I understand where he comes from. He drops down. He drops down from his perch and then comes down to fight me. But that's why he always confuses me, is because he drops down when I kill his friend. Hello. Goodbye. Okay, good. Looks like the conga's happening. Conga, conga, conga! Conga, conga, conga! Oh, for fuck's sake, come on. Come on. Stop. Stop holding out on me. Come on. Don't tease me like that. Ow. You can just fucking stop that in general if you want. Like, I could do without what you're doing. The life would be acceptable. Picking up their kit quite consistently. I mean, we don't need it, but we're picking it up. Hi, friend. I'm just hoping that your archer buddy over there hasn't clocked on. No, I don't think your archer buddy's clocked on to my presence yet. Those helmets, man, you know what I mean? Like, if your helmets are just, like, flat metal, it's kind of hard to see where anyone is. Drink. Drink. Very good. Got some friends who are going to pop down. They're going to take another shot at me. And then I'm going to promptly roll off the side. There is no need for me to fight him. There was no need for me to fight him at all. None. Like, I didn't need to go over there. That was me being dumb. That was me being cocky. By the way, we're gonna probably spend maybe 2-3 videos here purely, partially because the area, the like path leading up to the boss room is a bit of a dick, but also because if I recall correctly, the boss in this area is also a dick. But then again, that's speaking as a strength build. I don't know, maybe the Smelter Demon becomes child's play if you're playing as a dex build. I don't know, it wouldn't be the first time that I've discovered that to be the case. Where a guy who previously made me eat shit, just himself eats shit rather promptly. Come on, friend. Oh shit, you're alive. Okay. Ow. Stop it. I don't know why you always want to hurt me, friend. What is that life ring for? Wait, where is it? Oh, it just raises your maximum HP. I feel like I remember there being a ring in this game that actually just gives you passive health regeneration, which they always thought was weird. That might be in Dark Souls 1, in which case it was fine. No. No, I do remember that in one of the games, at least one of them, there was a ring that gave you passive health regen, and I never understood why they put that in. Because it meant that basically all you needed to do in order to heal was fucking sit still. Okay, good. Buddy's on his way. Good, buddy's dead. And now his other buddies are on their way. Come on, buddy two. Time for the pain train. Lovely. Let's get number three. Pain train! Lovely. Ow. As I've said it once and I'll say it again, you can stop that whenever you want. Whoops. Sorry, I don't quite have enough stamina to deal with you yet. Okay, now stamina's back. Pain train. Thank you for waiting. Now, I do wonder. I do wonder indeed. Okay, let's do any bolt. Yeah, magic bolt. Lovely. Unfortunately, they don't hit. And thus are useless. Well, back to plan A. Yeah, back to plan A. Now we're just gonna wait for him to fire again. His shot missed me completely, and now run into the room. To face the smelty demon. Who I imagine is going to, pretty promptly, fuck me up. Because such is my past experience with the smelter demon. Not helped by the fact that if you get too close to him, he does passive damage to you. Oh. Oh dear. Oh please, feel free to do your weird fire attack again. Okay, bit low on stamina to be doing that one, okay? Whoop, whoops-a-daisy. Calm yourself down, Smelty. You know what? Whoop. Yeah, I thought you were gonna do that. I don't think I can fully express to you just how proud of myself I'll be if I manage to take out the smelter demon in one try. I like first attempt. Oh god, he's gonna do it. Oh no, wait, he didn't, okay. Awesome! Okay, great. How? I don't know. But apparently I did that. Sorry. Okay, so I just dealt with a fucking enemy that, in my past with this game, the Smelter Demon has been the thing I've dreaded more than anything else about Dark Souls 2, because I cannot deal with the Smelter Demon. Feel free to fire. I will avoid. I'll probably fire at you twice. Then I will avoid. I will then fire at you twice. I will then avoid. And fire at you once more. And now I'm gonna deal with your friends. Come on, lads. Come to the pain train. The pain train wants to have a word. That, my friends, is what we call a double pain train. Right. So, what I'm gonna do is there's a bonfire through here. So, actually, before I do anything dumb, say leaping off there and losing all of my souls, I'm gonna go activate the bonfire first. I'm not gonna actually sit down at it because I'll reset the level, but I'm just gonna activate it. And then I'm gonna try, because there's some stuff we want on that platform. There's actually some good stuff in this area in general, which it may be worth trying to grab before we move on. Petrified dragon bone, that's always a good thing to have. Then up here, I believe we have a Pharos lock area. Can't remember what it does, but we have one. And we've got a lot of Pharos lock stones, so... Yep, no idea. It seems to have cried into a puddle. And that's about it. Oh, cool, we got a Zweihander. I look forward to not using that. not a strength build, are we? Okay, so now we can... As I said, there are several things we can do in this area. Several things we can... Fuck me! Ooh, we nearly leapt off the edge to our deaths. Nearly the end for us, though. Pull the lever. Which evens that out. Drop onto this catwalk. Turn this, which then turns off the flames. Yep, turns off the flames. That allows us to drop back onto here. Open up this door. Yep, because the flames are locked down there. Open up this door. Allowing for a second shortcut. Pick you up. Which another petrified dragon bone. Shuffle up here. Have a mild scrum. Not much of a scrum, but we don't have a mild scrum. A mild scrum, though. Sneak up here. Open this. Oh, no, well, we could have opened that. Oh, at least I was going to open that, but we can't. But then we can also drop down here. To deal with that guy, roll away. And now we've cleared this area. Lovely. Isn't it? Is it not lovely? Well, with the exception of that guy. But I don't want to risk it. I would not risk it for a biscuit, as they say. So, rest at our beloved bonfire. Get ourselves to our feet. Pull this open. Now, I believe down here, if I recall correctly, an old friend should emerge! Our beloved pursuer. Which, right now, doesn't bother me. But, as I'm sure you can imagine, when I found this guy to be the hardest thing in the game, well, one of the hardest things in the game, I'm sure you can imagine how happy I was to see him appearing in the same room as the other thing. I could do one of the hardest things in the game. Literally moments after when I went in to have a look in the room, suddenly, whoops, there's a pursuer. Yeah, I wasn't. I wasn't best pleased. I'm sure you can imagine. Ow. Could you not? Oh, fuck me. A sneeze when fighting the pursuer is not a pleasant thing to realize is about to happen. Whoops, you missed! Whoops, I missed. Also, a whiff against the pursuer is also not a thing you particularly want to happen. Ooh, it's been ages since you've hit me with that. Jesus. And that attack's long enough that I can actually take a swig. Whoop. Whoops. Come on, big fella. This one has a lot more health than they tend to have, it must be said. Come on, big fella. There we go. She dropped something. An upgraded version of the Ring of Blades. Huh. Yeah, a lot more health than I was expecting. That one. Then again, he also wasn't, like, spewing smoke, so I think he was, like, a slightly different pursuer. I don't know. Because there does seem to be two versions of the pursuer. There's, like... There seems to be, like, the clean one and then the one belching smoke. Right, well... I think... That is going to have to be all for me for now. The next video, I'm going to go spend some of these lovely, lovely souls I have on the on some level ups here. But but that'll be in the next episode. So that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your little nerd, I was thinking, and as always, keep calm, carry on, good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a terrible day when I made this video. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. All the same, if you're interested in seeing some live streaming stuff from me, if you look in the description, there'll be a link to my Twitch page, as well as a link to my Twitter in case you want to keep up with all the random gibberish I spew throughout the week. And if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always donate to my Patreon campaign, also linked in the description. Well, that's all from me. This video's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the sideways thinker. Do not seek the pardoner.